Hello people of the earth and welcome to QueenSafe TV. My name is Mike and today we're taking a look at Braid, the artistic game by, I don't really know whom, I don't remember, but I played it in the past. I actually have beat the game and I enjoyed it immensely, and I just wanted to present it to you right now as it was the part of a bundle. I don't even know why I'm doing it. Anyway, I just liked the game and I wanted to present it. Is that so much to ask? Now, the game itself is an artistic masterpiece. You run around in this very simple platformer, but if you take a look at all the surroundings, like for example this beautiful clouds, you see this beautiful design and etc. I'm going to go ahead and read you this small part of the world one in order to give you an idea of what is it happening here. Tim is off on a search to rescue the princess. She has been snatched by a horrible and evil monster. This happened because Tim made a mistake. Not just one. He made many mistakes during the time they spent together, all those years ago. Memories of their relationship have become muddled, replaced wholesale, but one remains clear. The princess turning sharply away, her braid lashing at him with contempt. He knows she tried to be forgiving, but who can just shrug away a guilty lie, a stab in the back? Such a mistake will change a relationship irreversibly, even if we have learned from the mistake and would never repeat it. The princess's eyes grew narrower, she became more distant. Our world, with its rules of casuality, has trained us to be miserly with forgiveness. For forgiving too readily, we can be badly hurt. But if we've learned from a mistake and became better for it, shouldn't it be rewarded for the learning rather than punished for the mistake? What if our world worked differently? Suppose we could tell her, I didn't mean what I just said. And she would say, it's okay, I understand. And she would not turn away, and life would really proceed as though we had never said that thing. We could remove the damage but still be wiser for the experience. Tim and Princess lounge in the castle garden, laughing together, giving names to the colorful birds. Their mistakes are hidden from each other, tucked away between the folds of time. Save. So this one is about time and forgiveness. And not only that, it's great experience just to like experience a story like this, right? You just read about it like a nice book. But at the same time, the game substantially helps you to figure it out how it actually would feel, but in the gaming fashion. Like, for example, how would it feel being able to reverse your mistakes? And as you enjoy this colorful scheme all around the place, the game is very simple, right? In the ways of controls and how the game plays, but it at times gets very difficult, but it's not the main part of the game. It's not about difficulty or not about design or not about any of this. It's about presenting the story in this very colorful and interesting fashion. Like, look at this, for example. Let us go ahead and demonstrate. Here I'm going to go ahead and do a mistake. Imagine if it was a mistake in relationship. Okay, I made her sad. Now I'm pressing shift and I'm going backwards. Honey, I'm sorry. I didn't really meant what I said. And now I can continue like it never happened. Now that's the idea. Now imagine each of you would have such power in your relationship, be you a girl or a guy, and you're just able to reverse any of your mistakes, like whatever you're doing. Like, for example, here. That was too rushful and I wasn't able to use the opportunity. Let me go ahead and reverse what I have just done. And these things, you know, even though it's a silly comparison, obviously it is so fun. It is so fun to experience this game and just play it the way it is designed with all these beautiful things, and I keep missing this goddamn curly guy. Curly guy, stop dodging me. Yes, that was not necessary. But here it will be. You can also do like small dancing with the shift button, which is a lot of fun. But the point of the game is that it's like, look at that. Whoop, 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 whoop. The point is, it's very beautiful, artistically designed. I like how everything is drawn in such a colorful fashion, as if it was drawn by hand, which it obviously was, as far as I can understand. Maybe I'm just making a fool out of myself, but it does look like it was a hand-drawn thingy, and it's just immensely beautiful. Immensely, immensely beautiful. The small puzzles in the game, they ramp up in the difficulty, which makes me really sad, man, because I hate puzzles, but I had to use a lot of playthroughs, you know, a lot of walkthroughs just in order to beat this game, because I really wanted to find out what happens at the end of the story in the past. It's a great experience, and it's amazing. You know, everyone, every single one of you should go ahead and try it. If you have the opportunity to get this game from a friend or buy it, I completely recommend it to you, because it's artistic awesomeness. It's very beautiful, even though it's a 2D platformer, you know, which is obviously not for everyone. I think it's a great game and an example of how games should be made, these artistic games, in 2D. Like, even without having a gigantic budget, you can still make something amazing and be proud of it. In every world, as we play, we go ahead and try to continue to gather these puzzle pieces, which help us to create a small illustration for each of the chapters. Sometimes it gets really difficult to get all of them, but generally you are kind of motivated to get them. That's why we have so many playthroughs on YouTube, in order for you to go ahead and check them out, so that you can figure out how to actually beat these small places, because they can get really difficult. Like in this one, for example, it's straightforward, you just have to hunt for these guys. You have to slowly go ahead and just chip them all away. But in different chapters, because the rules for the time and continuum will be different, it might get immensely difficult, right? In here, it's going to be very easy for us. We're just going to go ahead and deal with them. And as you can see, we get the puzzle piece. Amazing. But in chapter, for example, 4, 3, or 5, it's an immense pain in the ass. You wouldn't imagine. Yeah, that's right. In different chapters, they actually go ahead and often provide you the same situations or very similar situations in which you're trying to, in essence, to do the same thing. But because the rules of the world are different, it gets really, really tough. Like in here, for example, to solve this puzzle, we have to move the platform to the appropriate distance so that we get the curly guy on it and then let him go ahead and go where we want him to have him, right? We're going to use him as the boost for our jump in order to get this puzzle piece. Very simple, right? This is simple, but in different time rules, in different worlds, let's put it like this, it's going to be much, much more difficult, and not always the answer will be so obvious. But all it serves is to actually illustrate the wonderful story it presents, and the main part of the game, if you would have to ask me, I'd say it's design and the amazing story. That's all I care for. Not so much for this puzzle solving and gathering the stupid pieces of the mosaic, but because the mosaic actually illustrates what happened to Tim and to his girlfriend, to the princess, right? It's immensely interesting, you know, just to try to figure out what the hell just happened and why did it lead to the events that it led. It's just the artistic presentation of the story. It's like reading a book in form of a game. It's immensely interesting, and of course I would recommend it to anyone who's interested in such a game. It's not so valuable for its gameplay value. It's much more accentuated, you know, centered on the design of it and the beauty. Like, for example, look at this reference to the Mario. Ba-bam! Hello, Yoshi. I'm sorry, but the princess is in another castle. Talk slower, please. So here we go. This was the world one. This is the world, like, world two, world three. Probably the to the left is world one. That's what it's considered to be. But it looks quite shitty. At least the stars in the sky. That's the only thing that makes it happier. So that would be it for the presentation of the braid. I'd completely recommend this game for you, especially if that kind of games is something you're interested in. It's very interesting and it's completely artistic and the story is amazing. So I totally recommend it for you. And I thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening. If you enjoyed the video and my commentary, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel in order to support my work and get notified when new content becomes available. It was a great pleasure giving you this review today, taking a look episode today, and I hope to see you again on my channel. You have a great day and stay tuned for more content. Bye-bye.